Through fuzzing sudo with AFL, we have found a crash that looks very similar to the known sudo edit vulnerability. However, that crash is actually an abort because the heap seems to be corrupted. And this abort is just a symptom of a memory corruption that must have happened earlier in the program execution. And now we want to find exactly when the heap overflow happened. We want to find the actual root cause of this vulnerability. And there is an awesome analysis tool that everybody who works with C code should know. It's extremely helpful for debugging any kind of bugs, not only security bugs. But we use it because we want to learn more about this crash. And this tool is actually a compiler feature called AddressSanitizer. So let's create an ASan build of sudo to find the root cause of the memory corruption. From the fuzzing project, we can find a few tips to find bugs with compiler features, and it tells us about C flags like AddressSanitizer, fsanitize address. So let's add this to the build configuration from sudo. And because we are not fuzzing anymore with AFL, we can just use regular clang instead of AFL clang. Then let's build sudo with make, and in the outputs, you should see the usage of fsanitize address flag. This means it should work. Crap, build failed, linker command failed. But I think I forgot to set the LD flags for the build configuration. So let's run configure again, followed by make. And that seems to have worked. If we execute the binary normally, we can see that ASan is working because we get this report that there are some memory leaks. But memory leaks are not important for security. By the way, we can also disable the memory leak reporting as well. Now we have a nice output. So let's pipe in our malicious input and let sudo crash with ASan. Wait, it didn't crash? See the normal output here and then the unimportant memory leaks again? Wait, what? I'm going to run here into a really annoying problem. This killed a lot of hours and I decided to leave it in just to show you how I was troubleshooting the issue. Projects like this are never smooth. There are a lot of issues you run into. Throwing the input at the normal compiled sudo via our wrapper still works. So what the heck is going on? Well, there's a bit of an issue with this stuff like this. Recompilation, especially with massive changes like the AFL instrumentation or now address sanitizer, can move around the code in the binary and thus create a slightly different environment where the malicious input just doesn't cause a crash. It could also be that it only crashed because of some AFL stuff again. So something with the ASan build just seems to have changed. It's weird though, because ASan builds are usually a lot more fickle. It should immediately report an overflow case. And so it's kind of weird that it doesn't do that here. So where do we go from here? I guess we could maybe try the original crash, not the minimized one. Or we can increase the overwrite and the data, or generally modify the crash input a bit more. But when nothing seems to have worked while playing around, I eventually took a step back and I did a sanity check. I wanted to see if the argument parsing still works. So I tried to do sudo minus L, but I got the password prompt. I would have expected to see this output. So it seems like ASan has changed something important. But also that doesn't make much sense. You see here a typical weird technical issue. Somewhere I must have made a mistake. So I tried to backtrack even more. I wanted to remove the sudo modification that we have done to prepare the fuzzing instrumentation. I want to build a normal sudo with ASan where we can just specify the arguments directly ourselves. In the root folder of the Docker container, there is an unmodified regular sudo version, which I now build with ASan. All right, let's see. Sudo minus L works with that version. That is a good sign. And now we can create a symlink to zeroedit and then try to call zeroedit with the malicious arguments. But now it doesn't crash either. What the heck? Quick sanity check. Here is a previous Docker system where sudoedit clearly crashes, and that was built from the same sources, just without ASan. So I got really desperate. This is some really dumb mistake I'm making. And in my desperation, I decided to install this ASan sudo version as the system version with make install. Now I create a symlink from that new ASan sudo version as zeroedit, tried it, and now it worked. Address sanitizer, heap buffer overflow on address blah blah. I was so confused about this. This dumb mistake killed hours. But eventually I realized my mistake. For no fucking reason, the file source sudo is not the binary anymore. Previously, this was the path to the build binary. Now it's a shell script. And the real sudo binary is in .libs. Are you kidding me? How the fuck did that happen? If we symlink the actual binary in .libs and try it again, now we get the ASan heap overflow detection. I hate computers. Anyway, the overflow appears to happen in a function called setcmd, but it only shows us the binary offset in the object file, not the exact source code line. So I thought maybe I need to build sudo with the -g compiler option to create a debug build. To do that, I extend the cflex, so the compiler flex for the build configuration step, and then build sudo again. Let's see if that helps. Not quite. Let's check with gdb. I tried to set a breakpoint to set command and then run it, but it doesn't work. And when I looked more closely, I noticed the address range of the function. This looks like a library address. And when we look at the virtual memory map of the sudo process, we can see that this address must belong to some loaded library, maybe this libsudo-utils library. So it's probably easier for us to create a build without external libraries, a static build, by having everything in the same binary. That would make debugging and investigating a lot easier. And I think we can do that with the disable shared flag. Maybe you noticed that in previous builds I used that flag. I saw that from the fuzzing project tutorial and I figured I'd just use it too. When building with ASan, I didn't specify it. So adding it again should disable the creation of shared libraries and make this nicer to debug. Let's see. And by the way, that's when I noticed that disable shared flag influences if we get a binary in .libs or if source sudo is already the binary. So this was the reason why the binary used to be in source sudo and why now the ASan build ended up to be in .libs. This was the small dumb mistake that killed ours. So be careful with those build options. Now we have the new proper build with ASan and disable shared libraries. And when we test the crash, look at that. Now we get the clear information about the file and line where the overflow happened. Thank you, ASan. Let's look at it. Okay. At the correct line, we can find a loop that copies bytes around. It copies from this from pointer to the location of the to pointer. Also notice here that this loop seems to depend a bit on the check for a backslash. This could explain why the proof of concept crash had a backslash at the end. Now we can start analyzing the bug we found. By the way, in parallel of working through all of this, the AFL++ fuzzer found apparently 3 more unique vulnerabilities. So let's quickly triage them as well and see what their root cause is. Maybe we did find a 0-day after all. We can use AFL min again to minimize the other crashes. It goes very quick, and then we can look at all the minimized test cases. So this was the original one with the 0 edit and the minus s, and now the new crashes. Looks exactly the same. Minimized, they are also just variations of the sudo edit call to minus s with a backslash at the end. So they are the same crash, but as explained previously, AFL looks at the executed edges to determine if you reach different functionality, and it's a unique crash because other edges were executed to get here. Anyway, I'm still curious if regular AFL will find the bug, and of course if the test cases without specifically mentioning sudo edit will eventually discover it as well. Now we can keep the fuzzers running for a few episodes. But what could we do next? We could try and jump right into the exploit development. We have a crash. But maybe it will be too hard to exploit without better understanding the root cause of it. And having a better understanding should make the exploit development much easier. Also, the original Qualys advisory did explain in some detail why this overflow happened. So I think it would be beneficial for us to come to the same results. How do you figure out this detailed explanation? After all, the theme and the learning methodology of this video series is that we imagine we are the researchers, and we want to create a detailed write-up that explains what causes this crash. And this kind of investigation to explain the root cause is an important skill to learn and practice. So, let's do that next.